Hi everyone, this is Jayanthi Thalapathi from Gateway the Complete School. So today we are going to see the elimination reaction in halogenoalkane. Actually, we are going to eliminate halogen group from alkane. So halogenoalkane, for example, I'm going to give you one example, which is a secondary, right? Because the bromine react with carbon, so it's a secondary halogenoalkane, right? So with the carbon bonded with two other alkyl groups, so when halogenoalkane reacts with ethanolic NaOH, okay, ethanolic NaOH, so that means, so already we have seen in substitution reaction that we need water with ethanol, right? Same way over here, NaOH with ethanol. Why we need to prefer ethanolic NaOH? Why can't we the aqueous NaOH? I mean NaOH solution, NaOH with water. So aqueous NaOH, when it reacts with halogenoalkane, this produces alcohol, right? So aqueous NaOH, when it reacts with halogenoalkane, what will happen? You will get alcohol. That is what we have seen in primary and secondary substitution reaction. So over here, so when NaOH, ethanolic NaOH reacts with halogenoalkane, you will get alkene, because the Br will react with Na as NaBr and you will get a water molecule. So Br and hydrogen, so hydrogen from one of the carbon atom and the bromine from the this carbon atom removes as a HBr, have water and NaBr. That is why this forms alkene, okay? So elimination reaction in halogenoalkane, by adding ethanolic NaOH, you will get alkene as a product, not alcohol. So if you add water, you will get, if you add water with NaOH, if it is aqueous NaOH, it produces alcohol, okay? That is what we have done. Water with ethanol produce alcohol. But over here, ethanol with NaOH, ethanolic NaOH gives you alkene. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye-bye.